Hi there, my name is Mike Montgomery, and today we're going to build a simple, modern bookcase. I started this project by getting a couple 16-inch wide pieces of 3/4-inch plywood. This is what the case is going to be made out of. To start, I'm essentially just making a 30 by 30-inch box that I'll then be adding shelves to, cutting it into quarters. As you can see, I'm clamping a straight edge to my workpiece as I'm cutting so that I know each piece is square. The next thing I want to do is make some edge banding to hide the plies of the plywood on the side of the box. Now you can get pre-made iron-on or glue-on edge banding, but I want to show you guys how you can make your own really quick and really easy. Whenever you're using edge banding, one of the most important things is that your edge banding is the same species of wood as your plywood. I used pine plywood for my case, that's why I'm cutting pine strips. And I'm just cutting them about an eighth of an inch thick, then I glued them to the ends of my top and bottom plywood pieces. I used masking tape to clamp the pieces in place, then after about an hour, I could come back with a chisel to make everything super smooth and flush. I'm going to be attaching the case with screws, but I don't want the screw heads to be visible. So here I'm marking out places where I'm going to recess my screw heads. Essentially, I'm drilling a 3/8 inch hole halfway through my plywood. That'll allow the screw head to sit beneath the surface, and then I can come back later with a 3/8 inch oak dowel to plug up the holes from the top. Earlier I mentioned you should make sure and use the same species edge banding as your plywood, but using a different species dowel is a good opportunity to add some contrast and make your case a bit more interesting. I used oak because I know the end grain gets pretty dark when you put wood finish on it, but it doesn't get as dark as walnut, so it won't be too much contrast. As I mentioned, the shelves are essentially dividing the case into quarters, but the way they're put together is pretty interesting. In the center of each piece, I made a cutout so that the two shelves, the vertical and horizontal piece, would become interlocked. Basically, each piece has a half lap cut into it half the depth of the shelf. Then when I put the two pieces together, they become flush and are interlocked, like I said, and really, really strong. Next, I marked locations so that I could recess the screws just like I did in the rest of the case, and you can see me clamp this 12-inch speed square so that I made sure each of my drawers were parallel to the cabinet and everything was going in really straight. It was basically an extra pair of hands making sure everything was straight and square. After trimming the dowels flush with the rest of the cabinet, I sanded everything to 220 grit and I used my palm router to make a 45-degree chamfer on the outside of the case. This totally isn't necessary, but it adds a little bit of a sophisticated touch to the piece. The base is put together very similarly to the dividers for the shelf. I used the same half-lap joints, but just on a lot smaller scale. I used pine 1x3s, although I will say, if I were to build this project again, I would probably cut these pieces out of the scrap plywood from the case. I just used glue to hold everything together, but make sure while you let it dry that it's setting really square. I also used glue to attach it to the rest of the case. I just clamped it in place and let it set overnight. So most plywoods have an A side and a B side, meaning you have one show face, and then the back, which is supposed to be on the inside of the cabinet, isn't quite as pretty. And with pine plywood, it's especially not pretty. So I got some cool mint paint from Home Depot, and I used that to paint the insides of the cabinet. And then after I had everything cleaned up, I added two coats of satin polycrylic as a finish. So I'm really happy with how this project came out, especially the painted insides. Even though they were the fallback because of the ugly inside of the plywood, it actually became the highlight of the piece, which is really cool. If you're not already, I'd welcome you to follow us on our Instagram page and be sure to subscribe to stay up to date with all of our new projects. Thanks for watching.